Five games in the NHL tonight, including the Leafs hosting the rival Bruins, banged up Bruins. Coach Mike Babcock was asked if this was a measuring stick game for his crew.
Well, I think you guys, you say measuring stick and you say playoff game. Only playoff games in the playoffs. But there is games that you look at, like players. I know for a fact when we go in and play some games, just by how the guys are vibrating, that it's a real game. So we're playing Boston. It's a division game today. I think if we have all our pieces and they have all their pieces and you're playing head-to-head, I think it's different than it is today. And saying all that, it's the game we're playing. It's the most important game of the year because it's one we're playing. You don't want to hear any of that. That's the facts.
Hey, I love Babcock. You know it's a big game when guys are vibrating.
Yes.
That's right.
Big game. You know it's a big segment when Nick Kyprios is in the building.
Joins us in the studio.
I like how you doing, man?
I like hanging out here with you guys.
Well, we love having you. By the way, how fun was Saturday night? With
it was
the Baby
awesome.
Blues, Dave Hodge back in the building.
Yeah.
I was literally, I'm as jaded as you can get.
Yeah.
I was getting goosebumps watching that.
And I was in the studio early Saturday, and that was pre-taped, the Dave Hodge and Ron McClain interview. But I went down to watch it, and it didn't disappoint, I can tell you that. And what really kind of vibrated through the whole building was how emotional Dave was to come back in that scenario. And
really?
He spoke of it in the interview on feeling like he would never wear the jacket ever again and what it meant to him to put it on one last time and really feeling like there might have been some real closure there for him.
Yeah. Right.
Right? Yeah. That was awesome. And Ron's so generous and he's so grateful for what Dave Hodge and a lot of the other ones have done over the years for Hockey Night in Canada. But Saturday night, like, I've only been there a few years. You know, Elliot, Kelly Rudy, they've been around a lot longer. Just to be a small part of that really made you feel how strong the brand still is.
Oh, yeah.
Like, when you started looking at your social media and the response for Hockey Night in Canada, it's as strong as ever.
Well, some of the prices for the auction going on
right now.
There's some strong price. 12 G's? 12 G's for Don Cherry's jacket right now?
How about, okay, 12
G's. Yours is going for 50.
No, stop it.
50 G's.
We're all around 2,000, and then I look about 10 minutes ago, and I see Sean Reynolds, $2,500. I'm like, Sean Reynolds? Like, I like Sean Reynolds, but...
Do you know what he did?
No, hold on.
You know what he did?
I know what he did.
Yeah, there's a backstory there.
Oh, no.
So not only he signed his jacket, but he had Patrick Laine coming off the 5-goal game to sign it with the Hockey Night towel.
Smart.
So he signed the Hockey Night towel line, he did, so you can get both in that pack.
So now Sean Reynolds goes from maybe $250.
Huge promotion.
Maybe $300.
Huge promotion.
If maybe he gets a relative, an uncle, it's $500.
I'll tell you.
$2,500. So let me get this straight now. I'm going out. And like, who do I get to sign? Lady Gaga?
Yeah.
If she signs mine, maybe I start challenging.
Well, we just saw Ken Reed. He can help you out.
Ken Reed will sign mine, but
with
that's cheating, Sean Reynolds.
But it's kind of brilliant at the same time. You know who else is cheese? Kyle Bukauskas.
Oh.
That's not fair for Kyle either.
Oh, my God.
Like,
I'm like, when did Sean Reynolds become Ryan Reynolds overnight? Like, what is this?
The money says yes. The money says yes. Well, it's a great cause again. The auction closes tomorrow?
2 days. A little bit over 2 days.
Wednesday. Auction open until Wednesday, everyone, if you want to take part.
50 grand in total.
We're going over top right now.
There's some serious money coming in.
It's great. Good job, Sean.
Fantastic.
Whatever it takes to raise money, I'm with you, pal.
All right, let's move on to some of the news from the hockey world. And today we get Ron Hextall fired by the Flyers. We didn't have a lot of time to jump into this, but I found this remarkably intriguing. What about you?
Intriguing for sure, but there's so many layers to this. And I think on the surface you can look at it and say, hey, Ron, you didn't fix your goaltending issues. And that was a concern. And, you know, a lot of people look at Ron and say, hey, listen, once upon a time, you were a great goalie in the league, an all-star, Conn Smythe winner. How could you not find a goalie? And we know that Carter Hart's there and one of the top prospects, but he's struggling in the American Hockey League right now. He's not ready.
He's not ready.
So what does that mean? 2 years? 3 years? We're talking about goalies now coming into their prime at 26. How long you got to wait for this kid? He's only 20 years of age. Therefore, that's where the finger gets pointed to at Ron, I think, off the top. But after that, like I said, there's a lot of layers there. Here's the biggest layer, okay? The Philadelphia Flyer brand has gone south.
Yes.
Okay? It's a business deal as much as anything to start with a different philosophy, okay? What has happened now is they're probably fourth in the market there. The Sixers have passed them. Sixers is becoming hot. They made that big trade with Butler. Do I know my basketball? Look at the NBA chops on Kemper. So now all of a sudden, you got that being a hot ticket, and you got the Flyers now, people picking up tickets for $30 or $40. That's unacceptable in Flyer land.
I got news for you. The Philadelphia Phillies are about to, about to spend some serious money on something.
That's right.
So that brand's going to change,
And then you're in Saturday night. And you get squashed 6-0. There's no scrums.
You guys must have been losing. Like, you're watching that first period Saturday. What's going on in the room?
Penalty-free game. Yeah. Like, honest to God. I know that culture as good as anybody because I signed my first professional contract there. I got to live it the first 5 years, training camps, the farm system, training camps. That's as low as it got in 30 years that I've seen the Philadelphia Flyer organization, where you sit there and go, Like, say what you will, hockey's changed, no fighting, but those people haven't changed. I'm telling you, they're still.
The fans in that city haven't
changed. The fans haven't changed. The game has changed. 6-0
loss.
But they watch that and they go, I'm not paying for that. Yeah. And that was a big issue.
So let me ask you a tough question. Who signed you to your deal? Was it Bobby Clarke? Because he's still there.
Bobby Clarke.
Right? Like, yeah. Holmgren is still a part of that.
Very much still there.
Yeah. Well, another thing that happened is Ron also isolated a lot of the alumni, which didn't sit too well. And I know that there's a break point where you sit there and go, yeah, you got to let go of that old Flyer, like the Oilers, you hear a lot of that. Let go of the 80s. And you get that. But it got to the point where it was really uncomfortable for a lot of people. And I think what they really still believe in, even in 2018, is that we like to keep it within still a Flyer family. So what does that mean? Is it a Chris Pronger that comes in? People are dropping Daniel Briere's name in, who's done a nice job, but he's far too young to take over.
Family has worked. Like, they've been looking for a goalie past Hextall. How long has it been since he was in the net?
It's crazy. It is crazy that they have never solved the goaltending issue. Even JVR at $7 million. A lot of people are sitting there going,
guy you drafted.
He's not a typical Flyer, you know, who can bring it. He's a guy that just kind of finds his soft ice and scores.
He's very dimensional.
Doesn't really carry that old brand well. And, you know, people are questioning why weren't you in Tavares. Well, because he didn't want to be here. So what? Still make a run. You're the Philadelphia Flyers. You've been on every free agent the last 25 years. It didn't matter who was out there. It was just a foregone conclusion. You, as a Flyer, were going to bid on a top free agent. Right. To not even knock on that door upset a lot of people as well.
We're getting close to knocking on the door of Willie Nylander.
Yes.
And saying, what gives, man?
Well,
Saturday, 5 p.m. Eastern. What gives? What's the latest?
You know what? This is how crazy it is. There's people now telling me that there was a sighting at Pearson Toronto Airport on him. And I don't believe that's true. And I haven't made enough calls on it, but I don't believe that's the case. I can tell you as of today, and I don't know what's happened in the last few hours, but there hasn't been much talk in the last 3 days. So that tells me they're not close or the deal is done and they're just waiting it out. But my sense is still there's some balls juggling in the air right now still on this deal here.
What did this prove for either side? Like, who wins in this? And did the Leafs prove with what they were doing without him that they might be able to do something?
Well,
like a trade?
For sure. No question about it. And there's still people that still honestly believe, despite what the contract says, move him for a D. It's inevitable. You need a D. What's going to give? And Nylander's issue all along is, I'm going to sign that bridge, and maybe you keep me for this run. Maybe you keep me for the next year's run. But you're trading me. You cannot sign Marner and Matthews to the deals that we know that's coming their way and still think that you can afford me at $7 or $8 million. That's not happening.
Doesn't add up.
So I don't think that he's officially asked for a trade, but the one thing that's guarded him from signing up until this point was knowing that he was going to get traded the moment he signed it. Was it this year, next year? But he knows it's coming.
Right.
In 30 seconds, will Eugene Melnyk be the owner of that hockey team in 5 years?
He just won't go away. I can tell you that. I mean, he's hanging on. How he's doing it financially, people can only guess. But eventually, you got to think that at some point, there's going to be a cash call that he doesn't make.
Yeah.
And is that what everybody's waiting for? But certainly, if you're the league right now, and Gary, you know, to his credit, has done an amazing job of keeping the likes of Buffalo and Edmonton and Winnipeg back in the fold.
Arizona.
I mean, he's as loyal as the day is long. And I do believe that he's got a certain loyalty even to Eugene Melnyk. But once the cash doesn't add up, then all bets are off.
Yeah. A lot of people forget how Melnyk got in there. It wasn't the greatest situation.
No, it wasn't.
When he jumped in there.
So it wasn't.
I can understand that loyalty, but...
Oh, I'm right there with you, McAlf.
Can I push a button for myself?
Oh, more positive. One. More positive.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah, that's a little bit better than the first furniture one. Around here. Nick Caprio. Always appreciate you.
Okay, boys.
Thanks, bro.
Enjoy.
Nick Caprio.